Jack, would you please? I really need the review station right now.
Hey, okay, that's it. You are being evicted. Hello, everyone, it is Briximus Prime back for another Masters of the Universe action figure review, and today we're going to be reviewing the Masters of the Universe. Wait, hold on. And today we're going to be reviewing the Masters of the Universe, Masterverse, Scareglow. So yeah, let's now take a look at the figure by starting with his packaging. And now taking a look at Scareglow's packaging here. It's the classic Masterverse packaging right here with that fancy kind of square triangular shapes, Revelation, Scareglow. Get it? Scarecrow, Scareglow. Man, Mattel and their Master Universe names, like, you get Buzz Off and, like, Tuskor and, like, all these guys, and then you got Scareglow. Genius. It says Masterverse right here, and then here on the back, we got some amazing artwork, also here on the side as well, and it's got a bio right there. It reads, Scareglow, evil ghost of Skeletor. Fear his glow. The skeletal specter rules the underworld of Subternia, trapping lost souls inside of their deepest, darkest nightmares. But it has been too long since Scareglow has tasted true fear. If the daring adventurers wish to pass through his domain, they must pay the price. Fear for Scareglow to feast upon, or to be trapped in Subternia forever. Whoever does the artwork for this, please tell me they sell art prints. And now, taking a brief look at Scareglow's accessories, he comes with this kind of green battle axe thing here. It's not too impressive of a weapon, but it is pretty cool, and it is nice to give him something to hold. And I like the kind of plastic it's made out of. Very nice and sturdy. Doesn't feel like it's going to snap or break. And then he does come with some hands. Scareglow comes with a right fist. A left grabby hand. Scareglow comes with this like pinching slash grabby hand, or it's his way of saying that he's compensating for something. And just like in that Skeletor review that I did, I referred to this hand as the boy hand. And here is taking a look at Scareglow, and he looks really good. I love how this head sculpt came out. I like how it's that semi-transparent looking color, and they added in that extra little bit of black wash all over the face to really pick out the raised details on this guy. I really like it. The red eyes look really good, and obviously, as demonstrated once before, yes, this guy's glow-in-the-dark feature does in fact work. So I really appreciate that Mattel also went the extra mile to still include that. And yeah, I really love how Scareglow looks here. The other thing about him that I also really love is it's very subtle, but throughout the entire body, this black plastic here, it's more apparent here in the hands, but he has this very slight, he's made out of this slight transparent-y, smoky black plastic. So it makes him really come across as if he's a spooky ghost. I really like how, again, it's not really noticeable unless you really have him, like, heavily backlit. But he basically is made out of this smoky, transparent plastic. And look who's back. And like I said, overall, this purple material here, I like how it's got this very slight texturing detail right there. Really brings out the idea that this guy's wearing some cloth, even though it's made of plastic. Got some nice gray right there. And then they use this felt material back here for the cape, and I really like how the cape looks all torn up and everything. Very nice look. And then, of course, I also love how he's got all of this yellow bone detail painted all over the body. Looks very nice, especially here on the hands. I love how it continues all over the body. Would have liked for it to have continued more down the body and look a little more apparent, but at least it's down here on the legs, and it's down here on the shins even. They could have easily not made that not painted, but they did. The boots here look really nice as well. And overall, a lot of the details on this guy look really good. I really like how Scareglow turned out. He may not be Skeletor, but he definitely is close to it. Boop, boop, boop,
boop. Come on, let go. Boop.
He really doesn't like the axe. You having fun over here, Jack? Hey, hey, stop doing that. Going over Scareglow's posability, his head can look up that far, can look down that far, can rotate from left to right. Not really any head pivoting. Shoulders rotate a full 360, even with this shoulder pad thingy in the way. Arms can move outward that far. He does get a bicep swivel. Double jointed bend at the elbows. Also, one thing I should mention about the smoky plastic, like I said before, it doesn't feel like it's going to break either. It feels just as sturdy as all the other Masterverse figures that I've handled before. The wrists rotate and hinge up and down. And then his diaphragm joint right here allows for arching back, which can allow him to look up farther. And then it can crunch down to allow him to look down farther. And then it can swivel a little bit, but he does have a waist proper. Hips can kick forward that far. They can kick back not that far. They can move outward pretty far. He does get a tight thigh swivel. Double jointed knees that bend in pretty far. He does get a calf rotation right there. Ankles can move up. They can move down. And he does get an ankle pivot and then peg holes at the bottom of the feet. So pretty good articulation here on the Master of Sub-Eternia. Anyway, moving on to the size comparisons. Here is Scareglow with my last Masterverse figures that I reviewed, the two Skeletor figures from New Eternia and Revelation. And then here he is compared with Masterverse Revelation's Skele-God. And then here is Scareglow compared to Jack. Anyway, that's really it for comparisons. Thanks a lot, Jack. And that is basically it for my review on the Masters of the Universe Masterverse Scareglow. The figure is really good. He basically is just a repaint slash retool of Skeletor, but his painting and sculpting is different enough that it makes him feel so much more unique than Skeletor. I love his glow-in-the-dark head, I love the painting, and I love the idea of the semi-transparent plastic. And again, the figure feels solid, doesn't feel like it's going to break. The cape looks really good. And honestly, I don't really got a whole lot to complain about with this figure. The only thing I really could complain about is maybe the lack of some accessories, because there was an San Diego Comic-Con version of this figure that was released, and it came with a couple more accessories. I would have liked that version, but obviously this one was more affordable and easier to get. But still, I really like this Scareglow, and there's a reason why I like this guy just as much as my Skeletors. I mean, for no obvious reason, but yeah. So yeah, that is basically it for my review. If I had to give this figure a rating, I think I'm going to give him a solid, very solid 9 out of 10. So yeah, that is basically it for this review. If you guys enjoyed the review, be sure to give me a like on the video, comment down below what you guys think, and subscribe to the channel for more toy reviews, and I'll catch you guys next time.